Hello, everyone, and welcome to Medford Anywhere Learning TV. We're glad you're tuned in. We want to give a shout out to our friends at Southern Oregon PBS, KTVL, KDRV, and the Dove Network. Thank you for hosting us on your station. In the Medford School District, we have one shared vision, and that we believe that all are learning, and learning is for all. And what better place to do that than right here on Medford Anywhere Learning TV.
Hi, I'm Kristen Robinson, and I teach kindergarten at Kennedy Elementary here in Medford, Oregon. I am so excited today because I have a friend with me. Would you like to meet her?
Hi, boys and girls. My name is Sarah Mold, and I'm the Title I specialist also at Kennedy Elementary. And my title is just a big way of saying that I get to work with all of the students in our school, kindergarten through sixth grade, which makes it the most amazing job.
I love that Sarah is here, and I can't wait until we start our lesson, but let's talk about our learning target first, because it's pretty exciting. I can read common, age-appropriate, high-frequency words. You might have heard this word at school, sight words. What does that mean? It's words that you see in everyday life, like, I, we, more, and many. And then there's a second part to our standard. I can print all upper and lowercase letters. I know you can do this because you've been practicing your name all year. And that is what our two standards are today. But did you guess what we're gonna do? We're gonna write letters, not the kind of letters like A, B, C, D, E, but letters where we tell each other about things. We communicate and we share our thoughts and our feelings. You might have seen some kind of mail in your mailbox before that looks like this. Advertisements, and then things with lots of words called catalogs or magazines. Have you seen other kinds of mail, Sarah, in your mailbox?
Absolutely, Kristen. There's also that fun kind of mail that comes to your mailbox, like letters from friends and family, which makes it such an easy way to communicate during this time. Or sometimes there's maybe birthday cards inside of your mailbox. Or I also love sending postcards, because postcards you can send from lots of different places. Send a quick little note to your friends and family, but then on the other side you could draw them a picture or send a picture of the place that you're at. But I was thinking about letters, and I was thinking about postcards and mail, and it made me think about one of my favorite books to read that is about sending letters. But here's the funniest thing, is that the letters are being written by a dog. Is that the craziest thing? But it makes the story so super fun, and I can't wait to read it to you today.
I think that sounds absolutely amazing. A dog that writes letters? Sarah, I am ready to listen to this amazing tale.
So our story today is called Can I Be Your Dog? And this certainly looks like a dog that I would love, but he would have to replace my dog, Frankie, who's at home, who I love so much. So I'm sure you wouldn't enjoy that much. So here's the start of the story, Can I Be Your Dog? He looks like he's pretty talented writing with his mouth. Dear people at Yellow House, woof, can I be your dog? I am potty trained and I have my own squeaky bone. Also, I love to play. I see you have a cat, but I'm willing to work with you. Who's a good dog? I am. Sincerely, Arfie. And I love how he used his paw also to sign his name. I know every house on Butternut Street, but I asked you first. Here's the letter back from the owners. Dear Arfie, we're so sorry, but you cannot be our dog. Our cat is allergic to dogs. Good luck in your search. The Honeywells. Oh, he looks like he's pretty sad to see that response. Dear butcher lady, so a butcher is someone that will make meats and cut them up for us to eat. Can I be your dog? I think your butcher shop would be a great place for a puppy like me. I could keep the floor nice and clean. Signed, Arfie. I bet he could. He'd love to eat all the meats that would fall on the floor. Here's their response. Look, pal, I've got a bone to pick with you. Last time I let a dog into my shop, a dozen meatballs went missing. Sorry, but there's no way I'm taking in a pooch. Veronica Schenk, butcher. P.S. That means another little thought she wanted to add to the letter. No hard feelings. Enjoy these dried giblets and good luck finding a home. Oop, so we got a little treat, but still looking very sad. So here's his next try. Dear Fire Station Number 5, can I be your dog? I can fetch your boots. Plus, let's just say I know my way around a fire hydrant. Oh, a fire hydrant is what they use to get water when they need to hose down a house that's on fire. I've sniffed out every single one on Butternut Street, and yours is the shiniest. Signed, Arfie. Dear applicant, thank you for your interest in working with the Butternut Street Fire Station. Unfortunately, the position, a fire dog, has already been filled. We will keep your letter on file. Best wishes in your search, Station Number 5. I don't think Arfie liked their response much. Dear Junkyard Guy, I'm not gonna lie, you're my next to last choice. But these past few days have been rough. Rough. So please, can I be your dog? I don't eat much and I can bark if people try to steal your junk and stuff. Hopefully yours, Arfie. So the junkyard is where people can throw away their garbage. Dear Mutt, get lost. Oh, poor Arfie. Dear Last House on Butternut Street, can I be your dog? I see that your yard is full of weeds and your windows are broken and there's a funny smell, but I'm not picky, just lonely. Signed, Arfie. Let's see. Oh, return to sender. Nobody at this address. Oh, poor Arfie. He must be really sad. Oh, he found a box to sleep in. But look. There's a note on his box that says, to Arfie. Dear Arfie, can I be your person? I need a friend who will be with me no matter what, snow, rain, heat, or gloom of night. And I see that you already know everyone on Butternut Street. I know you'll make a first-class partner. With hugs and head scratches, Mitzi Whipple, letter carrier. P.S. If you agree, meet me at the big blue mailbox. So that letter came from the mailman. Oh, and there she is waiting for him. And here he comes. Oh, he must be so excited. But look, he has a letter for her. Dear Mitzi, you know what? My tail has been wagging ever since I got your note. My answer is yes. Truly yours, Arfie. P.S. Woof. Oh, he must love that scritch scratch on his head. The end. I love that story about writing letters, which made us think about how fun it would be to write letters of our very own.
That was the best story. I felt kind of sad, Sarah, when Arfie wrote his letters and he wasn't getting the response he wanted. But what a happy ending that the postal worker adopted Arfie and they had each other. So are you wondering what a letter might look like? Let's get started writing our letter. I brought a copy with me so you could kind of learn the parts of the letter. Let's review it before we fill it in with information. So at the top of our letter, we always put the date. And then we have a greeting. This says, dear, because I haven't decided yet who I'm going to write it to. And this is called the body, which means all the information that we want to put in here goes here. And then if you were writing this letter to somebody, you could choose love or sincerely as your closing. And then you'd put your name. Let's write a letter to Sarah, because I'm having so much fun with her today. I want her to know how great it is. So the first thing I'm going to do is write my date, and I'm going to use numbers because we've been working so hard on our numbers. So today's April 28th. April is represented by 4 because it's the fourth month. And then I do a slash kind of like my tally marks, and a 2 and an 8 and another slash because I need to put the year, which is 2020. And then I'm going to start on my introduction. Dear Sarah. And remember to use your capital letters because it's a name. And you can see already on my piece of paper, I have a comma, which kind of looks like half of a mustache. I always put that after I write, Dear Sarah, or Dear Hmm. And remember, my body is going to talk to Sarah. It's going to tell her what I'm thinking. I'm going to write with my sight words, or my high frequency words I know. I am having so much, because I am having so much fun with you. I can't believe how many sight words are in this letter already today. And I'm going to use an exclamation mark because my friend Katie was telling me that shows excitement. It's a line and a dot, just like a period at the end. And then I'm going to say, I can't wait to do this. That's one of those hard words with a TH at the beginning. Again. And I'm going to use with again. With you. And did you notice how I left space in between all of my words? I could put my finger down if I really wanted to make sure I had enough space. Now, I think I'm missing something on my last sentence. Let's see. The end of the sentence, I have to show the reader where it stops. Oh, yeah, a period. And then, if I was writing this, I would choose love. So I'm just going to underline it today so you know. It's going to say love, and then my first name, which is Kristen. That way, Sarah knows exactly who wrote this letter. So let's read it together. We have the date, which is April 28th, 2020, and then it says, Dear Sarah, I am having so much fun with you today! Exclamation mark. I can't wait to do this again with you. Love, Kristen. Now, if I was at home, I would need to put this in an envelope and make sure Sarah's address was on the front. And a stamp, because when we put letters in the mail, we have to pay to send them. I have something else to show you. That's super exciting. Sarah told us about postcards. I wrote her a postcard earlier, and I have a mail system in the studio that's kind of like a clothesline. So I'm going to send it to her right now. I'm going to clip it on, and I'm going to mail it over to her. All right, Sarah, here comes mail.
I think I hear some coming.
Oh, this is so much fun.
Oh, it's a postcard, and I love it because it has Jackson, Kristen's dog, right on the front. Just like we talked about, you can do a picture or a drawing on the front of a postcard. And it says, Dear Sarah, I can't wait until you come over soon. Love, Kristen. And it has my address there. I think I will send Kristen one back. And my dog, Frankie, loves Kristen so much. So I wanted to make sure he was able to say hello to her as well. And so I think I'm going to attach it to her mailing system again.
I can't wait to get the mail.
Here it comes, Kristen. Special delivery.
I love our studio mail system. This is so great. Oh my gosh, I got a letter from Sarah. And it has the body. It has an introduction and a conclusion and my address. It says, Dear Kristen, Frankie misses you. Exclamation mark. She's super excited and so is Frankie. He can't wait until he can visit again. Tell Jackson he says hi. Exclamation mark. And then she put a heart. Sarah, I love that she showed me a picture in place of a word. There are other things you can do at home when you're writing letters. You could even set up a mail system. I have a couple bins, and you can write letters back and forth to your family members. You could have one be an inbox and one be an outbox. So when you wanted the mail to go to somebody, you'd put it in the outbox, just like the mailbox. And then when it came back to you, it would go in the inbox. If you don't have any bins like this at home, look what else you could use. You could use a cereal box because it has a really great flap that opens, and you could just pop in the mail, and then you could put it out on a table. Some other things you can do that are super exciting, Sarah. Are you ready?
I'm super ready because you don't have to use different mailing systems to be able to mail things to each other. You can use really quick things like making your own maybe birthday card for each other. Or you can simply use just a post-it note and stick it to somebody's door in your house to be able to send them a note. Or you also could send them mail a very special way that Mrs. Robinson is working on.
I love this. It's kind of a funny way. I wrote a letter to Sarah. Let me show it to you first before I show you what I'm going to do with it. I wrote this last night, and it told her how much I love being with her, and I love movie nights. I'm going to turn it into a paper airplane, and I'm going to throw it at her. Remember, don't necessarily do it at someone's face, but you could do it in a big room. Are you ready? Here goes my airmail.
Oop, I caught it.
Wow, that was awesome. So another idea I had, I printed this really big picture of Sarah and I at a fun event last summer. You could turn this into a letter too, so that she could see the picture and remember all the good times we've had together. And I think she might have one more idea for us on special letters. She knows how to make her own letter into an envelope.
So you don't have to have your own envelope at home to be able to send letters to each other. You can actually make your own. So you can see here, I just took a piece of paper. I made sure to start it as a square first because that makes it a little bit easier when I'm folding things. And then you're gonna take each corner, fold it up into the middle, take the other corner into the middle, and presto change-o, you have your very own envelope. Super easy and a fun way of sending letters to each other at home.
I love that, Sarah. This has been so much fun today. I hope that you start thinking about letters in a little different way than you may have already, because it doesn't have to always go in a mailbox with a stamp. It could go to anybody in your house. You could write about all types of things you like to do together, things that make you happy, things you'd like to do together in the future, or things that you just enjoy about that other person.
Kristen and I just got through passing letters back and forth to each other, which reminds me of another job where their entire day is to send letters to other people. And I'm going to share it with you right now. It's called The Jolly Postman or Other People's Letters. I love this book because not only is there a story inside, but there are letters inside of the book as well. Once upon a bicycle, so they say, a jolly postman came one day from over the hills and far away with a letter for the three bears. And you can see the letter here addressed to Mr. and Mrs. Bear, Three Bears Cottage, the woods. Oh, and look, there's that stamp on there so it can go through the mail. And inside of their letter, Dear Mr. and Mrs. Bear and Baby Bear, I am very sorry indeed that I came into your house and ate Baby Bear's porridge. Mommy says I am a bad girl. I hardly eat any porridge when she cooks it, she says. Daddy says he will mend the little chair. Love, Goldilocks. P.S. Baby Bear can come to my party if he likes. There will be three kinds of jelly and a magician. I love how she was using her sound spelling for some of those words. So the bears read the letter, except Baby Bear. The postman drank tea, and what happened next, we'll very soon see. Off went the postman, toodaloo, in his uniform of postal blue, to a gingerbread cottage and garage, too, with a letter for the Wicked Witch. Ooh, and here's her letter addressed to occupant. That means the person that lives in the house at the gingerbread bungalow in the woods. Open now, don't delay. It sounds like it might be an advertisement. Let's see. Oh, and it is inside. There's lots of different supplies that she could purchase from Hobgoblin Supplies Limited. She could get a new cauldron or a bigger broom, or she could get some frog powder. Sounds like a fun place to shop. So the witch read the letter with a cackle of glee while the postman read the paper but left his tea. It was green. He probably didn't want to drink it. He wasn't sure. Soon the jolly postman, we hear tell, stopped at a door with a giant bell and a giant bottle of milk as well. Look, it's almost as tall as the postman. With a postcard for guess who? And here's his letter addressed to Mr. V. Big, Mile High House, Beanstalk Gardens. Oh, and inside here is his postcard. It says, thinking of you on our magic carpet tour. Ooh, those look like some fun places to join and find. And the postcard says, dear Giant Big, having a nice time, me, my mom, and your hen what lays the golden eggs. It's better than traveler's checks. Saw a bloke as we was flying down. He was bigger than you. I've took note of his address. Take care of yourself and your talking harp. I'll be back for that one of these days, I shouldn't wonder. Bye for now, your very little pal, Jack. You might remember Jack from the story of Jack and the Beanstalk. So the giant read the postcard with baby on his knee, and the postman wet his whistle with a thimble full of tea. So he just needed a little bit of tea since the teacups were so big for him. Once more on his bicycle, the postman rode to a beautiful palace, so we've been told, where nightingales sang. Nightingales are a kind of bird. And a sign said sold with a letter for Cinderella. There's a surprise. And the letter is addressed to Her Royal Highness Cinderella, the Palace Half Kingdom Road. Let's see what the surprise is inside. Dear Princess, we at the Piper Press hope soon to publish a little book for younger readers in celebration of your recent marriage to His Royal Highness Prince Charming. A copy of this book is enclosed for your approval. We trust this somewhat shortened version of Your Highness's most marvelous tale will not displease you. We also trust that you will be comfortable in your new home and live happily ever after. Your humble servant and loyal subject to be, Peter Piper. And it looks like the surprise inside is a little tiny book of her fairy tale. So Cinders read her little book. The postman drank apple cider, then wobbled off on his round again and again and again. Oops. Later on, the postman, feeling hot, came upon a grandma in a shady spot. But grandma, what big teeth you've got. Besides, this is a letter for... Oh. It says, addressed to B.B. Wolf, Esquire, care of Grandma's Cottage, Horner's Corner. Let's see what the letter says inside. Dear Mr. Wolf, well, that wasn't Grandma at all. We are writing to you on behalf of our client, Miss Riding Hood, concerning her grandma. Miss Hood tells us that you are presently occupying her grandma's cottage and wearing her grandma's clothes without this lady's permission. Please understand that if this harassment does not cease, that means if it does not stop, we will call in the official woodcutter and, if necessary, all the king's horses and all the king's men. On a separate matter, we must inform you that Messrs. Three Little Pigs Limited are now firmly resolved to sue for damages. You might remember the story of the three little pigs and what the big bad wolf was doing. Your offer of shares in a turnip or apple picking business is declined, and all this huffing and puffing will get you nowhere. Yours sincerely, Harold Meany. So Grandma read the letter and poured the tea, which the not so jolly postman drank nervously. Now the jolly postman, nearly done, so is the story, came to a house where a party had begun. On the step was a bear with a bun, but the letter was for Goldilocks. To Goldilocks, 24 Blackbird Road, Banbury Cross. It says, please do not bend. Let's see what's inside. Birthday wishes today. Pat a cake, baker's man. Bake me a cake as fast as you can. Carry it in on a beautiful plate and light up the candles. Today I am 8. To Goldilocks with love from Mrs. Bunting and baby. Oh, and it looks like the surprise is some money for her to spend. So Goldilocks put the money in the pocket of her dress, asked the postman to the party, and of course he answered yes. So once upon a bicycle, so they say, a jolly postman came one day from over the hills and far away and went home in the evening for tea. such a fun story about writing letters, just like we talked about in our lesson with Kristen. Thanks again for joining us here on Medford Anywhere Learning TV.
Sarah and I hope that you enjoyed learning with us today, and we thank you for joining us on Medford Anywhere Learning TV.
Thanks for tuning in to Medford Anywhere Learning TV. Medford School District is a place where all are learning, and learning is for all.
Gracias, señora bebé, por ayudarme a hablar español. Tú eres muy increíble. Adiós.
I'm at the school picking up my stuff. I want to wish all the teachers a happy Teacher's Day at 2020 quarantine.
Miss Hopkins, you are the best teacher ever. Heart you rainbow, because you're a rainbow.
Hi, Mrs. LaBelle. Hi, Mrs. Southmaid. I love when you read stories to us, and I like when you give us hugs. Happy Appreciation Week. I miss you. Bye.
I'm Mr. Gurtel and all the other teachers at Griffin Creek, and thank you for all you do.
Hi, Mrs. Bennett. I miss you, and I wish I can be in class with you today.
Teacher, I like you because you're so cool, and you teach us a lot of stuff.
Teacher, I love you because you help us stand on a ball.
Thank you, Misty.
And Mrs. Marcos and all the other teachers at Griffin Creek. I miss you guys all. And thank you for all you guys do. Bye.
Thank you for doing Zoom meetings with us.
Thank you, Mr. Pyle.
Thank you for teaching us at school and online.
Armistead! You're right. Shut up!
Thank you very much, Miss Hess, for being my teacher through this very hard year, and it has been hard, but thank you for getting through it, for getting it through, and just being happy and about it. And also thank you for inspiring me to work harder on the subjects that I have not yet mastered.
Mac teachers are flipping great.
Hola, señora Bennett. Gracias por traerme que me mandaste trabajo muy fácil. Y también gracias por hacer tus videos de YouTube.
Thank you for teaching us in school and online.
Thank you, Miss Edwards, for being the best teacher you can. My heart is filled with happiness. You bring joy and laughter to this classroom. Congratulations of winning Teacher of the Year. Happy Teacher's Week.
You're the best teacher ever. You're nice, kind, caring, awesome, and smart.
I'm so thankful to all of my teachers at Logos for taking the time and putting in the effort to get online classes up for us, and I miss them and I can't wait to see them again.
Hey, I just want to give a shout out to my teachers and friends at McLaughlin. Wash your hands.
This is what I know, and you miss us, and you've been working super hard for us, and thank you.
Mr. Blair, you're the best teacher in the universe. I miss you reading to me, playing the guitar, and birthday bombs. See you soon.